Have you ever dreamt of having your very own robot? Maybe one that can dance. Astro, dance. Of course you have. Who hasn't dreamt of a dance-off with R2-D2? Luckily for us, Amazon seems to share those dreams enough to warrant creating this adorable ball of silicon. Making its debut on the iFixit Teardown table, I give you the Amazon Astro, or at least a beta edition of it. Once upon a time, the Astro was conceived as a home surveillance device, a complicated feat by any measure, but somewhere along the way, that goal ballooned into a multifunction robot companion. So in addition to surveilling your home, Amazon wants this device to be able to play you your music, connect to your smart devices through Alexa, and be just relatable enough where you'd want to keep it around. That's an awful lot to ask for from a consumer-grade droid. And it kind of shows. From the short time we spent with it, we can say that Astro is not great at being an Echo on wheels, for now. But where Astro does shine is in its mapping capabilities. Those sensors dotted around the front and back of its body aren't just for show. The floor plans it creates are accurate enough for Astro to quickly and safely make its way around any space, within reason. MKBHD might have some thoughts, but I have some questions. First off, is this device ready for prime time, or will it be once it gets its software ducks in a row? If so, is it going to be easily maintainable, and will that battery be easily removable? Or is this thing just destined to be a pile of e-waste? Sorry, but nothing escapes this teardown table. Well, it's not going to tear itself down. Go to sleep, buddy. This won't hurt a bit. The first step of any teardown, where do I start? I want to find the battery and the driving mechanisms, and to do that I need the panel off. Luckily, we've got exposed screws on the underside, so that's where I'll go first. Starting with the screws near the rear stabilizer, let's see if I can pop off that wheel. It's a good start. The larger panel is next, but I'm still not really seeing a way into the guts, just more plastic panels. Poking around the body reveals a couple of plastic parts that pop away and reveal more screws. But look here, the storage bin lifts out and reveals the battery compartment, well labeled to boot. Items 1, 2, and 3 free the battery, and number 4 gets me the battery pack. I'm getting some pretty strong repairability vibes from this thing. This pack is rated for 14.4 volts and 61.92 watt hours. Lots of screws are holding the plastic together, but I'm pleased to see that there's no glue in sight. The pack slides out, revealing 8 18650s at its heart. At this point, I notice the push text printed on the plastic wheel. Pushing the rubber tab releases the wheel cover and exposes several screws. Now, hair and string are natural enemies to anything rolling around on the floor all day. Check the roller on your vacuum if you need proof, or, you know, your toddler. So it's awesome to see a simple process for removing the wheel and untangling whatever might get caught there. Trying to get into the wheel well reveals our first repair fail. Clips are fine, but glue? Not so much. There's exposed screws holding the front panel in place, but I still can't see anything that would help me remove the main panel. There's a few more screws in the battery compartment, so I'll try removing those. Still no joy. The larger white plastic panel has give, but it's the gray rear sensor panel that seems to want to come away. Sure enough, a gentle tug releases the entire gluteus maximus, and disconnecting a single cable frees the entire assembly from the main body. Astro's butt has a lot of empty space in here, but that's okay, because this isn't a cell phone-sized device. The more it has to carry, the more limited its range is going to be, so lighter is better. These proximity sensors earn their ride by ensuring Astro doesn't run into anything, or anyone, when it's reversing. An absolutely critical system that I'm happy to see is quite modular. Now this brush back here is interesting. This is obviously no Roomba, and that brush is nowhere near big enough to clean anything. Given its proximity to the charge port, I'd say it's a means of controlling static discharge. An interesting design, and not one I've seen anywhere else. It took us a while to finally figure out that this piece here is held together with clips and glue. With these screws out, we can finally remove the largest panel covering up the internals. Now this is a much better view of the entire system, and I can already see where the power management is likely happening on this shielded PCB under the battery. Popping off the panel on the back of the neck reveals another PCB. The electric motors are next to come out, and I've got to say, they feel expensive. We saw firsthand how quickly Astro can move, a nippy 2 miles per hour or 1 meter per second. That is fast, and it's all thanks to these brushless beauties. I'll go out on a limb and say that these are contenders for the priciest components inside this device. Now, I'm curious to see what's on the front sensor panel. Like everything else in here, it's a pretty modular piece that slides out, albeit with a good bit of poking and prodding. This cable is labeled as a grounding cable, but holy moly, that seems overkill. Well, it turns out that this wide braided cable is a radio frequency ground. The front sensor assembly is layered between heat sinks and a single fan. Fairly easy work taking all this apart, but these sensors and cameras must run hot. The cosmetics of the device are particularly beautiful. Right from the start, this module looked like Astro's heart, but opening it up reveals the gorgeous colors in both the housing panel and the central lens. Alright, I'm going to remove and open up one of these headlight looking things. Unscrewing the four Torx screws on the PCB reveals two sensors. At a guess, I'd say the top sensor may be IR. Let us know in the comments if you know what type of sensors we're looking at here. Let's remove that USB-C tray to get it out of the way. Now we can get a really good look at our third brushless motor, which is responsible for the left and right motion of Astro's neck. Now, one of the nicer features on Astro is the amazing sound quality, and that's thanks to this hefty speaker module, which slides out without much of a fight. Now that the speaker system is out, we can get a good look at the underside of Astro. I can see brushless motor number 4, and I'm wondering if this is the periscope mechanism. Opening the circular module reveals two toothed plastic belts, each with its own coax cable running the length of the belt, all the way up to the camera, flash, and sensors on the periscope. This belt looks to run about 9 feet from end to end, and motor number 4 is responsible for feeding that cable through the neck to extend or retract the periscope. I cannot imagine how difficult it must have been to design this system. No doubt, I'll find out how difficult it's going to be to put it back together.
It's time to Marie Antoinette this robot and separate its head from its shoulders. The victim is unceremoniously dragged onto the teardown table for further experimentation.
And we arrive at brushless motor number 5. This one is responsible for tilting the screen up and down, which together with the neck motor helps Astro mimic the kind of movements we'd expect from intelligent life. Let's take a peek under Astro's face. No sign of glue, that's a positive. Just a few clips that come away easily enough. An antenna here, a few flex cables there, and some screws securing the hinge is all it takes to separate the screen from the neck slash periscope housing. Taking the heatsink off this board reveals even more thermal paste. I'll need to remove some cables and antennas to get the board out, and just look at all this goop. Nothing wrong with it, it's not glue, but it's surprising to see how much heat management these boards need. And with that, our teardown is complete. So just for a change, how about we build it back up? This little guy turned out to be both repairable and surprisingly well organized for such a complex device.
While I can't speak for its utility, I can say that it would have a promising future as a repairable robot companion, provided Amazon provides the parts, which is unlikely.
Voila! I give you Astro the post-apocalyptic companion bot, complete with a shout out to one of the greatest robots to grace our screens. This is our last video of the year, and we do hope you enjoyed it. But don't fret, if you're looking for more gadget gut goodness, head on over to our channel and check out our 2022 Teardown playlist. Give us a like and a subscribe while you're there, it really helps our channel out. From all of us here at iFixit, we wish you a Merry Fixmas and Happy Holidays. We'll see you next year.